Hi, my name is John Terhean, and I'm a Senior Solutions Architect Specialist for DynamoDB. Different databases excel at supporting different access patterns. DynamoDB, for example, is focused on transactional workloads and can provide single-digit millisecond performance at any scale. If you want to use that same data for other purposes, though, such as analytics or business intelligence, adding a purpose-built data warehouse like Amazon Redshift to your application allows for the best of both worlds. Amazon DynamoDB zero-ETL integration with Amazon Redshift makes keeping data in sync simple. In this video, I'll walk you through how to set up a zero-ETL integration and show you how to use Amazon Redshift to make some complex queries against your DynamoDB data. Let's get started. As you can see here, I've already created a DynamoDB table to use for this demonstration. I've also configured a few settings that are required for zero-ETL to Redshift. First, you can see that I've turned on point-in-time recovery. Second, you can see that I've set up a resource policy to allow zero-ETL permission for my table. You can configure both of these settings ahead of time before setting up the connector, but if you forget to or have any errors, the setup process will help you fix them. I've also loaded my table with data from a public dataset from the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. This data has values for temperature, pressure, wind, and precipitation for different times and places around the Earth. With a high cardinality partition key like station ID, DynamoDB could easily read and write millions of these records per second. Let's say we want to do a little bit more with our data, though. I'll hop over to the Redshift console now. Here, I've already created a serverless namespace and workgroup that we can use in this demo. Now I'll click on zero-ETL integrations to create our connector. I'll choose Create DynamoDB Integration and give it a name. Next, I'll select my table. Finally, I'll specify my Redshift target. Oops, looks like I have a problem with my resource policy and I forgot to enable case sensitivity in Redshift. Thankfully, setup will help me fix this. Here's the settings that'll be changed. Once I say OK, I'll wait a few minutes for the changes to take effect and we can continue setup. All done. Now I can finish creating the integration. Everything looks good, so I'll click Create. I'll need to wait for this to finish creating, then I can add my database. I'll refresh to see if it's ready. Now I can create my database from the integration. I'll need to wait a few minutes while the database is created and populated. So let's fast forward a bit. And it's active. Now we can open Redshift Query Editor V2 and connect to my database. Once we're connected, we can see my table. It was created as well. First, let's do a simple star select query. You can see our data has three columns. One represents our DynamoDB partition key, station, one our sort key, date, and one represents the entire DynamoDB item in JSON. This is using the super data type. The super data type is used to store semi-structured data like our DynamoDB items. Redshift can use particle to navigate into this super data. Let's do a query that does that. This query returns various values like temperature, data, and location from within the super type. Now let's take it a step further and use a query that would be very difficult to do efficiently with DynamoDB alone. Let's find which station recorded the highest average temperature within 100 kilometers of a given location. With Redshift, this is simple. I can see the highest temperature recorded was 89.1, and it was 96 kilometers from the location I specified. Now let's update this item in DynamoDB and watch it move to Redshift. We'll change that high temperature We'll query DynamoDB for that specific station and date, and we'll modify the average temperature. To 89.6. End-to-end data movement typically takes about 15 to 30 minutes, so we can fast forward a bit here as well. Now let's run that query again. You can see the average temperature for that record has been updated. Hopefully this has shown you just how easy it is to set up a zero-ETL integration. DynamoDB is a fantastic database for transactional access patterns. And with zero-ETL integrations to other data warehouses and databases like Amazon Redshift and OpenSearch, you can enable additional access patterns on that same data using purpose-built databases. Thanks for joining me today. Again, I'm John Terhune, a specialist solutions architect for DynamoDB. See you next time.